God, who have taught us to chasten our bodies for the healing of our souls. Enable us, we pray, to abstain from all sins and strengthen our hearts to carry out your loving commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. Lord, great and awesome God, you who keep your merciful covenant for those who love you and observe your commands. We have sinned, been wicked, and done evil. We have rebelled and departed from your commandments and your laws. We have not obeyed your servants, the prophets, who spoke in your name to our kings, our princes, our fathers, and all the people of the land. Justice, O Lord, is on your side. We are shamefaced even to this day. We, the men of Judah, the residents of Jerusalem, and all Israel, near and far, in all the countries to which you have scattered them because of their treachery toward you. O Lord, we are shamefaced like our kings, our princes, and our fathers for having sinned against you. But yours, O Lord, our God, are compassion and forgiveness. Yet we rebelled against you and paid no heed to your command, O Lord our God, to live by the law you gave us through your servants, the prophets. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, do not deal with us according to our sins.
Lord, do not deal with us according to our sins.
Remember not against us the iniquity of the past. May your compassion quickly come to us, for we are brought very low.
Lord, do not deal with us
according to our sins. Help us, O God, our Savior, because of the glory of your name. Deliver us and pardon our sins for your name's sake.
Lord, do not deal with us according
to our sins. Let the prisoners sighing come before you. With your great power, free those doomed to death. Then we, your people, and the sheep of your pasture, will give thanks to you forever through all generations. We will declare your praise.
Lord, do not deal with us according to our sins.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be merciful, just as your Father is merciful. Stop judging and you will not be judged. Stop condemning and you will not be condemned. Forgive and you will be forgiven. Give and gifts will be given to you, a good measure, packed together, shaken down, and overflowing, will be poured into your lap. For the measure with which you measure will in return be measured out to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Recently, I was over a friend's house and we were looking through some of her photos of her youth, and she was really reluctant to do so because she was so embarrassed of her behavior. But then again, who's not going to be embarrassed by the silly, immature behavior of a 10 when you're 10 or 12? We go through our past and we see ways that we haven't shined, not necessarily being immature, but maybe remember things that we've done wrong. You go in the past and see, because of our immaturity, you may have sinned against God and against our neighbor. Daniel is going through the past of Israel, and he's remembering and having Israel remember the times that they have sinned against the Lord and against each other. Yet he does not do this so that they can feel ashamed. Well, I guess so, but not for the end itself for them to be ashamed, but no, to remember what the Lord is compassion and forgiveness. With the Lord, So the turning towards their sins makes them remember, yes, that they're sinful, but the Lord's compassion and forgiveness is greater. And so it then turns them back to God and back to their neighbor. We're encountered in the Sermon on the Plain, in Luke, in the Sermon on the Mount, the command to be merciful. Often we see the needle or the splinter in each other's eye, but not the beam in our own. We have two paths when we think of our sins. We either harden our hearts and then take it out on the other because we see their sin so well, or we remember God's forgiveness and then we take that forgiveness and share it with those so that they too can remove the beam from their eye. You see, God presents to us today two paths: to be merciful or to be hard of heart. Let's take the path that God has laid for us, to remember our sins each and every day, not so that we harden our hearts in shame, but know that we receive God's forgiveness. We turn to Him, we receive it, and then we turn to our neighbor and give it to them as well. Trusting in God's mercy, we bring our petitions to Him. The Lord may abundantly bless the church with faithful disciples who are merciful as He is merciful. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The Holy Spirit may bring peace and unity to all nations and peoples, especially the Ukraine. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may sustain and comfort those who are grieving the loss of a loved one. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's abundant grace may come upon our catechumens and candidates as they complete their initiation into the church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the suffering, especially Marie Isabel, Lua Jackson, Geraldine Kerr, for all those who are on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may gather to Himself our beloved dead and welcome them into His loving embrace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Eileen Cato, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask that You grant these petitions according to Your holy will, through Your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are You, Lord God of all creation, for through Your goodness we have received the bread we offer You, through the earth and work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are You, Lord God of all creation, for through Your goodness we have received the wine we offer You, through the vine work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God.